Hey, how's it going, everyone? Prestige here, and today I got an exclusive first look at the Access Granted pack for Watch Dogs. This is the brand new DLC that just came out yesterday first for Season Pass holders. If you don't have the Season Pass, it will be available on July 1st to everybody else. There's no set price for this, but I suspect that it'd be between $5 and $15 because there is a ton of content inside this one DLC. So, with that said, we're gonna go over some of the stuff that's in it and what you can expect to see. There's actually three brand new missions run by DedSec that Aiden can do, and inside these missions, you'll actually earn some specific content depending on what mission it is. Like, for example, if you do the signature shot, you'll unlock the barometric rifle, and this actually reminds me of an ACR. This is a really awesome rifle. It's a 5-star rifle. It's really powerful. It's got a slow rate of fire, but the damage output is amazing. The other weapon that you'll get is the Auto 6 weapon, which is actually included with the Cyberpunk outfit. A lot of people suspected that it would be the Cyberpunk gun, but it's actually called the Auto 6. There is no Cyberpunk gun anymore. Now, you also get a bunch of bonuses. You get an investigation bonus, a vehicle expert perk, a DedSec battery boost, a bloom weapon perk, a driving master perk, and an ATM hack boost. Each one of these actually give Aiden a specific boost, and some of them are more easy to tell what they are than others. The investigation bonus actually gives you more videos while hacking data banks. So if you want to go in and see people's personal lives and see what's going on there, you're more than welcome to now with this investigation bonus, which is cool because it adds a little bit more depth to the game after you've completed all the single player missions. Vehicle expert perk is awesome because you can earn free car deliveries and you also get discounts while purchasing the vehicles. Although I don't really see a point to that because there's not too much reason to use money in this game. I've noticed that it's just very, very easy to earn money, but it's not that easy to spend the money, which is kind of strange. Moving on to the next, the DedSec battery boost. This is self-explanatory. You get one extra slot for your battery. So instead of having the 6 spots, you're going to have 7 now. So that always helps. Next up, we have the Bloom weapon perk. This is going to reduce the recoil on all your weapons drastically. Comes in handy when using light machine guns and other types of assault rifles. It's really awesome. I enjoy it. We got the driving master perk. This is actually a ability that gives you more hit points on your vehicles, so you can actually do more damage to other vehicles and have less damage taken to your vehicles. So that works out for everybody. The ATM hack boost is also self-explanatory. You're going to earn more money after hacking ATMs. So that is it. Also, with all of those come the additional outfits. We got the Viceroy outfit, Cyberpunk, DedSec, Bloom Agent, and Chicago South Club outfit. Each one of these outfits are the reason that you earned each one of those perks. So it doesn't matter if you have the outfit on, you will have the perk regardless because it's within the DLC. So if you want to have the barometric rifle, you're gonna have to complete the signature shot single player mission. The other two missions, they're okay. I mean, if you've completed the game and you have nothing else to do, this is definitely an awesome thing to have. It adds about, I mean, with everything in it, if you take your time through the single player missions, the 3 single player missions that are available, I say you can probably complete this little DLC pack within an hour to an hour and a half. It doesn't really take that long if you go straight from mission to mission. There is a small investigation where you need to locate hard drives, so that adds about another 20 to 30 minutes of gameplay. But then again, it's just like those investigation missions before when you go around and look for the dead bodies that are around. So that rounds up the Access Granted pack. Like I said, if you want to get hands-on time with it today, download the Season Pass. Otherwise, you'll have to wait until July 1st. Like I said before, though, I'm not sure exactly what the price is going to be. I estimate somewhere between $5 and $15 because there's a lot of content in this single pack. So anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider leaving a like down below and also consider subscribing for some more awesome Watch Dogs content right here on the channel. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.